Hello, 3D printing friends. Today on the BB3D channel, we're going to install the Micro Swiss all metal hot end on our Ender 3 Pro 3D printer. Stick around and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BB3D. Hi, welcome back. I've been using the MicroSwiss all-metal hot ends on my Monoprice Maker Select Plus 3D printers for over a year, and I thought it would be nice to have something like that on my Ender 3 Pro. Fortunately for me, MicroSwiss makes a drop-in replacement for the stock Creality hot end, and this kit works on the CR10, CR10S, Ender 2, Ender 3, and Ender 3 Pro. Is there a benefit to having an all-metal hot end on your printer? Well, consider that the stock Creality hot end has a PTFE tube that goes all the way down into the melt zone. The melt zone is the part of the hot end where the filament actually gets melted and squirted out the nozzle. PTFE doesn't like temperatures above about 245 degrees C. It can start to deform or degrade, and over time that'll make it harder to print or can lead to jams. The all-metal hot end doesn't have a PTFE tube. As its name implies, it's all-metal. It has a titanium heat break separating the hot end from the cold end. And titanium doesn't like to transmit heat, so much like the McDonald's McDLT from the 1980s, the hot side stays hot and the cold side stays cold. With the stock hot end, you can print PLA, PETG, and ABS. With the all-metal hot end, you can print higher temperature versions of PETG and ABS, as well as other high temperature materials like polycarbonate. This kit includes the following items: a heater block, a cooling block, a 0.4 millimeter plated wear-resistant nozzle, a silicone sock for the heater block, collet clips for the pneumatic fittings, and installation tools. The kit costs less than $65 US. If you're interested in it, there's a link in the description. In addition to the tools which are included in the kit, you will want to have handy the tools which came with your printer, an adjustable wrench or pliers, a Phillips head screwdriver, and maybe a 6 millimeter socket. The installation is actually pretty easy, so let's head over to the workbench and get started. We'll start with the printer already cooled down. If your printer has a silicone sock on the heater block, remove it and set it aside. Using the control panel on the printer, heat the nozzle to the working temperature of the filament you've got loaded. Once the nozzle is up to temperature, remove the filament. Then secure the end of the filament onto the spool to prevent tangling. With the nozzle still hot, unscrew it using the small wrench that came with the printer. Or use a 6 millimeter socket. But remember, the nozzle is hot, so be careful not to burn yourself. Then, use the control panel and set the printer to cool down. Wait until the nozzle has returned to room temperature before proceeding. Leave the printer on because the cooling fan continues to blow across the heat sink to cool it faster, and you can see the nozzle temperature on the screen. Once it's cooled down, turn it off and unplug the power cable. Press down on the collet ring of the pneumatic fitting at the top of the hot end and pull upward on the Bowden tube to remove it. Remove the two screws holding the fan shroud and fans on the hot end. Set the screws aside and move the fan shroud out of the way. Be careful not to damage the wires. Remove the two screws holding the stock hot end to the carriage. Be careful because the heater cartridge and thermistor are still connected and the wires are fragile. Remove the screw holding the thermistor in place. Then loosen the set screw holding the heater cartridge in place. Slide both the heater cartridge and the thermistor out of the stock hot end. The titanium heat break is packaged with the cold end. Remove it from the cold end, it's not screwed in, and then screw the heat break onto the new heater block and tighten it with the included 7mm wrench. Screw the nozzle onto the new heater block and tighten it just finger tight. Install the heater cartridge and thermistor into the new heater block, being careful of the fragile wires. Tighten the set screws which clamp the heater cartridge into place. Then use the screw to keep the thermistor in place. The thermistor screw should go between the two wires, and it should be just snug, not super tight. You just want to keep the thermistor in place, not crush the wires. Insert the set screw into the hole near the bottom of the cooling block, but just enough for it to stay in place. Attach the new cooling block to the carriage using the included screws. Make sure the hole with the set screw is facing the front of the printer. And make sure that both screws are tight. Insert the titanium heat brake into the cooling block. Make sure it's seated all the way into the cooling block, and then tighten the set screw. Plug the printer's power cord in and turn the printer on. Using the control panel, heat the nozzle to 230 degrees C. Use an adjustable wrench to keep the heater block from turning, and use the included 7mm wrench to tighten the nozzle. This will prevent molten filament from leaking around the nozzle during printing. Tighten the screws, keeping the heater cartridge in place. And tighten the set screw that keeps the titanium heat brake in place. Then use the control panel and set the printer to cool down. Wait until the nozzle has cooled to room temperature before proceeding. Since the cooling fan isn't blowing across the heat sink, it'll take longer than usual to cool down, but you can monitor the nozzle temperature on the screen. Once it's cooled down, turn it off and unplug its power. Now that the printer is cooled down and turned off, install the new silicone sock onto the heater block. Insert the Bowden tube into the cooling block and use the collet clip to keep the fitting tight. Then push the Bowden tube as far as it'll go into the cooling block. It won't move far, we're just getting it seated. Reinstall the fan shroud onto the carriage using the original screws. Now that the printer is back together, you'll need to adjust the bed height. Anytime you perform maintenance on the hot end or the nozzle, it's a good idea to do this because the nozzle may be higher or lower than it was before you started. So level or tram your bed using your preferred method, and then get printing. The MicroSwiss all-metal hot end needs less retraction, and in fact, MicroSwiss recommends setting your retraction value to no more than about 4mm. My personal experience is on the Ender 3 Pro, about 5 to 5.5mm seems to work really well. You may also need to print a little hotter, maybe 5 or 10 degrees Celsius, depending on the material that you're using. There. See, I told you it was pretty easy to install. And with that, we're at the end of the episode. If you made it this far, thanks, and thank you also to those of you who like, comment on, and share these videos. And a big thanks to those of you who subscribe to the channel. If you're not already subscribed, why not click that subscribe button down there? And if you want to know when I release new videos, click that little bell to be notified. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up. If not, give it a thumbs down. But either way, leave your thoughts down in the comments. If you like the content that I'm producing and you'd like to help out, consider supporting the channel with a one-time micropayment. You could buy me a coffee or leave a little something in the PayPal tip jar. Links for those are down in the description. Also, check out the affiliate links in the description. Using those when you're buying printing supplies, filament, or even entire printers doesn't cost you anything extra, but it does help the channel and it helps keep me making content for you. Well, now that I've got this MicroSwiss all-metal hotend installed, I'm going to go print something cool. You do the same, and I'll see you next time.